hands, everybody, if you got what it takes. Cause I'm Curtis Blow, and I want you to know that these are the breaks. Breaks on a bus, breaks on a car, breaks to make you a superstar. Breaks to win and breaks to lose, but these here breaks will rock your shoes. And these are the breaks. Break it up, break it up, break it up.
This is Action News Network and True Indian Productions, Rush Delivery, a special report. It's not even a crisis in South America, it's really liberation in South Africa. I think I said South America, but South Africa is like liberation, right? Like I said, I've been, you know, noticing white people bugging out, man, between what's going on in South Africa and these bombings in Austin. You know, it's not safe out there, yo. Like, these dudes is really bugging, man. When they start bugging, people die, you know. Usually their own people, because you know how they live and stuff like that. But, yeah, people die, yo, so you gotta be careful out there, you know, especially if you're in Texas right now, but anywhere, because this shit is about to hit the fan, man. These people, they mad, yo, and they know their time is up. They know their time is up, yo. You know, they being smited right now, man. Yo, all this shit that they did to all these melanated people, especially aborigines, because they have a real thing with getting us, boy. You know what I'm saying? They really do. Because the brothers and sisters of South Africa are aborigines too, you know, they look like they have the same skin color as us, for the most part. It's going to be crazy out there, so I just suggest everybody just pay attention to your surroundings, man. We're going to get into it, we're going to take a look into what's going on in South Africa. It's very important, and I'm hoping that some of my aborigines here, who are mislabeled as African American, can wake up, man. Why you think we call it knowledge itself, man? How you got knowledge itself? You still calling yourself African? That's not knowledge itself. That's knowledge of him. It's knowledge of them. You know what I'm saying? But it ain't knowledge itself. It ain't knowledge of who you are. It's like this band that says, "Keep calm, stay indigenous, man." This, you know, because a lot of people, I see a lot of chatter like, oh, we should be able to do something here. And I'm like, oh, so you know we Indian, right? And they like, what? And I'm like, how you gonna kick people, how you gonna kick white people off this land when you're not from here either? You know what I'm saying? So think about it, yo. Think about it. That's how you know you Indian, because it slipped out of you. You're like, yo, you're gonna kick these people out of here too, but you how? If you African American, you don't have no, you don't even have a country, a nationality. How you gonna kick anybody out anywhere? You can't even go to Africa unless they throw your ass in Liberia, Sierra Leone, or something. So, you know, we gonna get into it, man. And keep calm, stay indigenous. You know what I'm saying? So let's roll. We gotta cut. It's not gonna be a long video, but you know. We're going to get into it, a couple of points and stuff like that. Like I said, this is a rush delivery. I didn't really plan on doing this, but I've been seeing a lot of crap go on, and it's making me mad. This kind of goes along with my, check out my other video for where the white people come from. You know, it's just a synopsis. You know, I just made that because, you know, I was getting into a couple of arguments with some white folks about something, and they always snarkily trying to, like, talk, low-key talk crap about us and stuff, so... I just wanted to just prove facts to them. So, you know, to all my good white brothers and sisters out there who are, you know, doing the right thing and stuff. Just like, you know, I don't give in to stereotypes of negative African Americans and what they do or whatever and crap. Just because I'm a black man doesn't mean that you have to stand in solidarity with these assholes too, you know.
Yo, white people is bugging, yo, on some real shit, man. Like, this whole thing going on in South Africa, I never really understood the white people. They're kind of like spoiled, especially white men. Alex Jones, I have like a love-hate relationship with him because he is conscious to a lot of things, but then he's also very agently, number one. And number two, you know, like with most white people, their inner racism comes out all the time, and he's no different. He's probably a nice guy in real life, and I believe he's passionate about what he does, which I can respect. But you know, and I expect people to, you know, go with their race. But what's good is what's right is right, and what's wrong is wrong. And honestly, this whole thing in South Africa is crazy. I mean, how do these people, you know, the way they talk about it, like the South Africans should be like thanking the whites for coming and taking their land and making the country more prosperous by colonizing it. Like, how dare you tell people like us who've been colonized, you know, that we should thank y'all for that? That's the most disrespectful BS, you know, you can think of to just say. Like, I really don't think these people like think before they open their damn mouths. This is what happens when you're used to being on top all the damn time. For generations and generations, you become stupefied and lazy and spoiled and like I said, stupid. Because it's stupid. That's like telling a rape victim that she should be she should thank her rape victim who had a baby because of the rape. Yo, she should be thankful to the rapist for giving her the baby. You know, like, who says crap like that? You know, listen to this rhetoric. And I probably won't F with Alex Jones for a long time now. You know, I'm pretty much done with this one right here. And then the snarky comments, you know. And this is why I was so mad about the Black Panther thing. Because I knew this crap was going to happen. With all y'all dumb Negroes going crazy for the Black Panther movie. All right? And just listen to this crap, all right? And he has this South African white dude, Afrikaans, or whatever the hell they call themselves, and weird ass Dutch South Africans and crap.
Why is Africa so corrupt? Once the evil colonists are kicked out, then you should have, you know, Wakanda.
You hear this crap?
It should be like spaceships and, you know, the vibranium and everything, which would be great. I mean, I love Africa. It's a beautiful country.
This is how he tries to make himself seem like he's not racist.
I want them to do well, fellow humans, but
it should be like a Wakanda. Like,
brought the civilization. Why does it then recede back?
These people really think they're gods.
Everybody's starving, but the, you know, president's son has 100 Lamborghinis.
Let me put it to you this way. Shortly after that chap, Cyril Ramaphosa, our new national president, was elected the president of his party prior to becoming the national president, he and a group of senior people went to Nelson Mandela's
their accents are so damn annoying.
As a chief, and they sought permission to go to Nelson Mandela's grave to shake his bones. That is to say, to invoke the ancestral spirit of Nelson Mandela to reinvigorate.
And to tell you the truth, the reason why
Congress Party,
how are we?
Just evacuate.
Fake news.
No. Our forefathers built this land with faith in God, blood, sweat, and tears, Alex, and they built something beautiful. We will not go. We will not capitulate to the face of barbarianism. It's
and they call us whiners.
We will stand here and
this guy's a crybaby. He wants to cry so badly.
They're going to kill you and then kill themselves. You can't help them.
They're going to kill themselves. We don't commit suicide, melanated people. Y'all do.
Almighty God, we will stand and fight and die here. Watch us.
No, I actually respect that. I understand it. I know what you guys have been through. It's been hellish. I mean, you've been really good to the locals. Built everybody up. Population exploded. And there's a lot of Black folks that actually don't want to see everybody go. But
yeah, they
get hacked up, don't they? I read about it all the time that the Blacks that want to work with everybody, they get killed, don't they?
Yeah, it's a very, very big problem. problem. That factor is referred usually as intimidation. So in other words, anybody who doesn't toe the party line gets chopped to pieces. There are tens of thousands of examples.
Didn't Winnie used to hang the gasoline tires on little kids' heads? Her favorite thing she said was hearing little kids' heads pop. And then they like to do that.
Where's the evidence of that? I'm going to have to research that.
Simon Roche is a leader of a Christian organization. And I've studied the factions and things. It's very fascinating. I've read quite a few books on it in South Africa and how the country got set up, the different factions that were involved, the Zulus and then the ANC and then the Afrikaners, the Dutch, that were Protestants, and then the British came in the Boer War and Winston Churchill. I probably only read 8-9 books on it. That sounds like I'm bragging. That's not a lot. It's very interesting.
All right, that's enough of that. I mean, how dare, you know, these people? And you see the solidarity between colonizing whites, right? Because Australia is going to take some of these people in, you know. They're not fleeing for their lives. The black South Africans just want their fucking land back. They're indigenous to that land. You came in and took it. You took the farmland. You didn't enslave them like you enslaved us, but you put them into a different kind of slavery. All right, there's different types of slavery. Essentially, all Americans right now are in voluntary servitude anyway, if you're not sovereign. Okay, so you know there's different forms of slavery. We were chattel slavery, and then the worst, we were done the worst because they committed paper genocide to us. The American whites are just plain fucking like on some different shit of evil. But they did a lot of killing of blacks. They used to take the pregnant women and split them, like cut them in certain parts and tie them to stage coaches and, and they would, the coaches would run in different directions and the stomach would split and the babies would come out. You know, this is fact. Just like, Christopher Columbus, when he came to Puerto Rico, where my family, descends from, part of it, my mother's side. He was actually feeding his dogs that he had on his ship who was starving after, the journey going through the Atlantic. He was feeding the babies to them, like roasting them and spearing them, and then in the South they was the gator bait with the babies. It would snatch up babies from the slave quarters and use them as gator bait, and literally let the gators eat the babies to catch them. And we're supposed to feel sorry for y'all. We're supposed to what is this? Two wrongs don't make a right crap. Like, F out of here, bro. Like, for real? Like, these people are crazy. They're delusional as hell. Delusional and spoiled crybabies. I'm sorry, man. Like, I'm pissed as hell. Y'all try not to talk about, other people by racial categories or whatever. Like, oh, white people do this, do that. But this story's got me pissed. These people think that you was gonna live like this forever. And to my, we'll continue on. I gotta take a minute because, these people really got me pissed because they just so goddamn spoiled and stupid. And it's like everybody has to go along with their stupidity and this stupid matrix that they got everybody in. All right, here's the president of South Africa. I'm gonna take this off of the clear. What we're going to do is we're going to listen to him talk a little bit. And we need to wake up, man. Africa's taking back their continent,
Jacob Zuma, president of South Africa, it's great to have you with us today. I've heard you recently warning Western corporations of pursuing a colonial approach to Africa. What exactly does that mean?
Well, the colonial approach that we are talking about, as you know, Africa is the only continent in the world that was colonized by Europe, totally. We had to fight what we call the anti-colonial wars to free ourselves. And they were bitter wars, they were not just small wars, very bitter. When Africa became free, there was no arrangement how to make Africa develop. So they were left as they were. Up to this day, in some of the African countries, you still have the armies of the former colonial countries. What do they want there? Still have a mentality that they look at you as a former subject when they do business with you. And the fact that we have not shifted in terms of how the economic relations are, that's a bigger problem. The companies that dominate these countries come from the former colonial countries. In no way you have the indigenous companies growing to be in charge, so to speak. So that's a kind of relationship which is very skewed. It's not balanced. And there's been no effort to them who have the means to help balancing the relationship. That's not what we're talking about.
All right, so you see, the brother here, he's making a good point, you know, like, these people came in and stuff, and they basically wrecked shit and made a lot of wealth for themselves and stuff and left the indigenous population to rot. And if you notice, you know I talk a lot about Africans and stuff like that, but I also tell you that there's aboriginals in Africa. There's people who are aboriginal to Africa. Not everybody on that continent is aboriginal just because they are all black one way or another. What most people think of sub-Saharan Africans, which you would call Congoloids, which is those in the central part of Africa, what they say that we're descendants of, and we look nothing like them. Well, these people down here in South Africa, they mixtures of the Zulu and the, it's like the Zulu, a couple other tribes, and I know the Sands people is down there, the ones with the slanted eyes. They live in, like, you know, the desert to the north. But, you know, look at these copper skin, just like us, most of us, you know. And Nelson Mandela was the same way, you know, and he had the slanted eyes. You know, he had Asiatic eyes, too. So you could tell, you know, who's indigenous and who's not. But, you know, like, I digress because it's not what we're talking about here. But the brother's making some good points, you know. I just like to throw little tidbits in there sometimes, you know. Like, try to educate and just make a drop whenever I can. But he's making a really good point. We're going to continue, though, and listen to some more points that he's making. Interesting to listen to this. This is his feelings on what Europe owes to Africa.
I'd like to get back really shortly to what we're saying about the colonization of Europe by Europe. There is also widespread belief that Europe, because it colonized Africa completely, like you said, at some point they just left Africa with disease and ruined economies, and they're morally indebted towards Africa, not only economically. Do you believe that also? Is Europe indebted?
Of course, yes. They messed up Africa. Not just they're indebted, they actually messed up Africa. They should have corrected their mistakes if they thought they committed some mistakes. In other countries, they did nothing. They did not development. But in the majority of cases, they sucked the wealth of that continent into their countries and made their countries rich and did not develop Africa. That's the reality. If things were equal, they would have said, look, let us do something to help these free Africans now to develop. They just abandoned Africa.
But what about China? Because everyone knows that China has a large appetite for African resources at this point. How do you make sure that they don't become the new colonialists of the 21st century?
They can't be. They can't be. China is not colonizing anyone. Europe held a conference to discuss how to colonize Africa, took a resolution collectively. China has not done so.
He's right.
They
paper
came
balls
to Africa
and stuff.
Not to do business. They came to Africa to colonize. Mm-hmm. That was their mission. China's mission is different. They're coming to do business in Africa. And I know that many people ask that question. China's doing business in Africa.
All right. I still wouldn't trust China all too much because the Asians, they have their own agenda too. You know, as a people, you know, they are colonizing, you know, they're just not doing it the European approach. They're doing it a much smarter way by pretending to do business. And, you know, much to what he just said about how they came in and just left and stuff like that. They didn't really help and nothing like that. It's the same thing with us in America. You know, not only did they come in, we helped them, we fed them, we taught them law and stuff like that. We had a nation already going on here. We was already uniting tribes to make a nation. You know, we had like a united tribes almost here and stuff like that.
But they came in. We let them join us. They basically bopped us over the head, gave us amnesia. When we woke up, we was enslaved, and they told us we was from Africa, you know? And we forgot that we're from America and that we're aboriginal to America, right? So same thing. They had the opportunity to repent. You know, generations after generations decided not to do anything. They just, you know, after slavery, there was Jim Crow. And after Jim Crow, there's, you know, the drugs in the community and other stuff, you know. One of the worst things that ever happened was, you know, the desegregation, you know, like integration and crap. You know, we did better when we was on our own, when we did for self, you know, we was more self-sufficient. But yeah, man, they had opportunities. The kids, the grandkids, the great-great-grandkids of the slave owners decided to make more laws and more ways to make our lives miserable instead of repenting. So it's hard to feel sorry for these people. It really is. You know, it's like, boo-hoo, I'm sorry. I just don't feel sorry for you, you know, for what you did to, you know, these people, my people, in the whole goddamn world, basically. Even your own people. Look at all the wars y'all caused and people that died. Look what's going on in the Middle East. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody, you know, y'all want to start crap, but then when, you know, you get punched back in the face, then you want to cry, you know, victim. Play victim. Okay, because this is what I do, I notice real disturbing patterns, right? And the pattern that I'm seeing as disturbing is they really trying to kick off a race war, man. You just seen the South African president. I just showed you what happened with Alex Jones and the white South African dude, right? And his feelings and stuff. What are we talking about here? Like, Maxine Waters was asked this question out there. I wish she's from California, I believe, and crap, not too far from where I'm at right now. The issue in the United States of what, reparations, right? Just came up out of nowhere, you know. All of a sudden, with everything going on, you know, the only thing on black folks' mind and crap is just reparations. And now you see this thing going on in South Africa, where they basically taking back their country, you know. And now listen to this right here. You know, keep in mind that, you know, we just had this this reparations crap just come up, right? And stuff. So just keep this in mind, right? When you listen to this brother right here.
Well, in Rupert, we discussed with you about reparations which Africa could get from the British colonialism. What do you claim?
I think the first point that I make is that reparations has no meaning outside the context of imperialism and anti-imperialism. And so what we've got to do is we've got to give some sense of what imperialism is. Now, I'm just going to do it in a shorthand way. Imperialism is theft. That's what imperialism is in a nutshell. The imperialists go around the world, they steal from other people, particularly they steal the land of other people, and then they enslave the other people in their land. Now that's called colonialism in a nutshell. When the imperialists go, they heap war against you and steal your land.
But now African countries are formally independent, so land
That's
should
right,
be
Robin.
Probably back to Africans or not.
Well, what we have is a funny situation in the history of Africa. We've had imperialism impose slavery onto us. We fought and defeated slavery. Then it imposed colonialism onto us.
Kind of take a little bit of offense to that,
we
but
fought
okay,
and we
go ahead.
Colonialism. And now what we have is a new phase, neocolonialism, a new colonialism, where we, on the surface, appear to control our land. But in fact, economically, we do not have control. So we're now in a third phase of getting rid of neocolonialism. And in essence, it is the getting rid of neocolonialism that will be the reparations.
All right, y'all heard that, you're right. You heard the brother, right? He just said reparations. And all of a sudden, all melanated people who've been colonized, we just all coming up with out the woodwork with reparations. You know, the indigenous Africans in South Africa, you know, they trying to cut their own, you know, reparations. It sounds like other countries are getting on board with the same thing. And this is at the same time that in America, you know, with Maxine Waters or whatever, you know, and all of them, they talk about reparations and all. You know, this smells like a George Soros operation or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is going to be like a new Black Lives Matter for this year, you know? I want to say the double F word, you know, when something is made out to be a distraction and crap, and it's a double F, you know, it's two words, FF, and it rhymes with boss hag. This is a boss hag, all right? A boss hag on some real. It really is. Because I can't say the double F word because, you know, I might get, you know, flagged or something like that. Funny word to use, right? But, I don't want to get flagged, but this is a boss hag, okay? This is a distraction. You're not going to get reparations as an African because you're not African. They didn't take you from Africa. The few people they took from Africa, the families have amalgamated into our community to the point where you couldn't even prove that you're one of the people that came from Africa. But there's tons of treaties and stuff here. There's war crimes that could be committed against them. We were our ancestors were prisoners of war. They was at war. Just like the president said in South Africa that the Europeans planned to colonize Africa. They got the paper bull to come get us Saracens, the Hebrew Indians, and searching for the Moors, who they kicked out of Europe. You know, and who fled over here to our sanctuary, our paradise, the Americas, and essentially led these people over here, and who enslaved us and took our land and took our identity, because now they straight up took our identity, because there was enough diversity on this continent, you know, between us copper colored, you know, aborigines. And the mongoloids who, you know, came over from Asia and the West Coast. I mean, it's crazy. You know, they basically just wiped us out, man. So y'all need to wake up, yo, so we can get this going. You're not gonna get reparations. You know, this is the reason why we haven't got it. You're not gonna get it. The Africans might be able to get it because they're indigenous to their land. But y'all idiots is running around in no man's land because you saying that you're African when you not, and they know you not. At least the people who gotta write them checks know. I mean, your senator might not know, but yo, I mean, it even depends on who's your senator, how high up there they are. You know, you don't think that the higher echelons know? They know who you are. They know whose land they stole. The general public don't know. Just like I showed you Waka Flocka Flame. What do you tell you when you go out of country? The people in France know who you are. The people in England know who you are. The Russians know who you are. And these Africans damn sure know who you are. Alright? They know what happened. So yeah, I hope y'all getting empowered and emboldened watching the Africans do what they doing. So we can stand up and take our own land back. Because yo, these people, they dying off, man. These Neanderthals, yo, they dying off from drugs, suicide, and they not reproducing. Only made 5,000 kids last year, so it's a wrap for them. You know, so y'all need to get your act together so we can, you know, get together, and we may be able to do something like this. And you hear all these forced news, you know, crap about, you know, they're killing the white farmers down. They not. And remember, white people bugging, man. When white people bug out, people die, yo. You know, when they get rejected, when they start fucking getting depressed and all this other shit, people die. All right. So you need to do your P's and Q's. You know what I'm saying? And stay firmly on your square, because it's coming down. You know, and they really pushing this race war. They really are, but it's not gonna work. Because they want to exterminate us. So they want a reason. They want a reason to sick those militias up on you. I don't care how gangster you think you is in your neighborhood or whatever. Them rednecks will body you quick, alright? So like I said, man, just be vigilant. You know, build a cipher. And just stay safe, man. And you might want to get some canned goods and stuff like that. At least 3 days worth for you and your family. Cause y'all, anything's gonna happen, alright? So don't get caught with your pants down. This is Action. Action News Network. This is a special report, quick report. And smile, kid. Peace to the guys and nerves. Later.